When we last spent time with Governor Schaefer, he was in very good spirits.
It's an honor to get up for anybody.
Hello.
It's
so nice to see you.
He was warm and typically sarcastic as we toured his apartment at the Charlestown Retirement Center.
Nice place.
You like it?
No, I hate it.
He wanted to talk, and we wanted to listen.
I'm old now, and I'll be gone in a short period of time. But being able to do something for somebody else, even to help a lady across the street, now that sounds like not public service, but it is. Go into a yard, and the yard's filled with trash, and you help her clean it up. I know that sounds hokey, but that makes you feel so good. You walk out with a swagger.
Any regrets?
No, I can't say I have any regrets. People have treated me nice. Now, don't think that it's been roses and peaches all the time. There are people that don't like me, and they let me know that they don't like me, and I'm sorry for that, but I don't like them either, so we're all even.
But the people who liked this man, who adored him and formed his inner circle, offer extraordinary insight into this brilliant and complex longtime public servant.
So let me just ask you, moody?
Unbelievably.
Cantankerous?
Unbelievably.
Difficult?
Unbelievable.
Complicated?
Unbelievably.
You loved him?
Loved him to death.
Perhaps no one was closer to Schaefer than Lainey Lebo, a confidant and sometimes controversial gatekeeper who could predict his mood just by the position of his shoulders.
More often, was he up or was he down?
I would say more down. And that down was a way to get people to gather around and do more and figure out what would make him happy. Everybody wanted to make him happy. It's the most incredible thing.
It's a very intense experience.
Mark Wasserman was a senior policy advisor, campaign manager, and chief of staff to the governor.
Like a lot of elected officials, he was an introvert, even though you wouldn't know it. So he really needed people he trusted. Many major political figures have this. And so it's just one of those great fortunate accidents of life. I became part of what some thought were sycophants. I'd like to think we were close, but professional.
Former Associated Press reporter Tom Stuckey.
More so than anybody I've seen in my 40-plus years of covering politics. I've never seen a circle of friends and staff that were so personally loyal to an official as I did with Schaefer's people.
He had no way to relax, no family support to turn to. And so we were all very much part of many dimensions across his life.
And a lot of times I'll refer to him as like my favorite uncle.
No one can do Schaefer like former spokesman Mike Golden.
I would go into his office, and he would always feign disgust, or I guess that's the right word, but he would go, "Oh God, what do you want? Oh jeez, oh," and I would, I'd have some business conduct and say, "Governor, could you sign this? Why don't you go your hat?"
He said that to you every day?
Pretty much.
Bishop Robinson was Schaefer's police commissioner in Baltimore, his public safety secretary in Annapolis.
I liked the guy when I first met him. He was very forthright, and he said what he wanted to say, and he never had any problems with it. And I sort of liked that, and he had guts.
One of Robinson's favorite memories has to do with the prison break and the governor's ability to perform after arriving on the scene.
I was there. So then he said, "Look, come here. Look, Bishop, I don't know a damn thing about prisons, I don't even know what's going on here. So I'm going to talk to you, and you just talk to me. And don't let the people get too close to us. And I'll be pointing at things, and you say something." I said, "Okay, good." So he said, I said, "There's the hole where they got through the fence." Oh, yeah.
So he knew to look interested and engaged.
Yes, you got it. Everybody thought he was really into it. That's amazing how this guy was. He's one of a kind. There will never be another one like him. Never.
What piece of advice would you give to the next generation of public servants?
Love public service as I do. It is the greatest thing in the world.
It seems hard to imagine anyone loving it the way Schaefer did, an unconditional love to the end. Deborah Weiner, WBAL, TV 11 News.